Happy 2024, and welcome to the second episode of Mike's Big Marshall Folder Exploration Journey. Yeah, that really rolls off the tongue. But in our first episode, we took a look at four different knives in the Cold Steel Voyager series, comparing the large 4-inch size to the XL 5.5-inch blade size, and comparing the drop point to the clip point. And in that video, I teased that the next one we would be covering in the Voyager series would be the rather uniquely shaped Voyager Vaquero, which is an XL size knife, 5.5-inch blade, supposedly one of Lynn Thompson's favorite everyday carries. In a recent video I watched, he said he carries two, probably the plain edge version along with the fully serrated version. Well, I have the plain edge version, so that's the one we're going to take a look at. And while we're at it, yeah, I'm probably going to have to draw some comparisons to similar sized and shaped blades, including, yes, the XL Voyager clip point and the large Espada. So let's get into it. All right, this is another case where you're not going to see the out-of-the-box edge because I've been carrying and using this one for a bit. Like the other Voyagers we looked at, you've got the same Austin A blade steel, same hardness that is somewhere above 60 HRC according to my files. This is a fully flat ground blade with a very keen secondary edge bevel, very sharp, but this blade, by design, it's supposed to be more martial than utility. And we talked about the usefulness of the martial knife that's also a good utility knife, so therefore you carry it, use it, get familiar with it, have it on you. So we will be taking a look at how good this knife may or may not be as a utility knife compared to other blade shapes, as well as my martial impressions of it. But like, well, the other Voyagers, you know, the box really keen, that belly is, you know, something you can work with in different ways, that recurve. Flat grind means going through thicker materials. Here's a nice thick triple wall cardboard. Ah, yeah, that is really slicey as a utility blade. So let's talk about specs and build. We don't have a sheath to talk about, so this is where we talk about carry dimensions, your folded specs. Now, like the other Voyagers, it comes with the GrivX hard plastic grip scales with the super sharp aggressive diamond pattern that I'm always tempted to sand down a little bit to make it more friendly for my delicate hands. I would definitely recommend doing it a bit under the clip because that can be really rippy and snaggy on your pants when you go to deploy it. So, yeah, pop the clip off and maybe just smooth out right underneath it. Speaking of popping the clip off, it's a curved clip. It does come with a second one if you want to reverse it left to right, but there's no option for reversing it tip up to tip down. Speaking of tip up, just like the other XL Voyagers, that clip is kind of low. So that's about how much is sticking out of your pocket, and I'll demonstrate that in carry, which includes a little bit of exposed shiny steel. But the upside of that is you've got some real estate to grab onto to deploy it. So there's the good and bad of having it riding a little bit high. Inside, you've got the full aluminum liners and the super durable triad lock, which has served me very well, held up very well in all examples. But as I mentioned in a previous video, from the factory, a lot of inconsistency with fit and finish. Of all the examples I've had, I never know what I'm going to get. Sometimes really smooth out of the box, and sometimes it's super gritty or super stiff or both, even to the point where sometimes I go to open it and it gets stuck, and I have to hit it with something to break it free. And as I mentioned, I might do a video on how to smooth up break in a triad as a separate subject. But as it turns out, this one came to me out of the box nice and smooth, so it didn't need any break in. But let's talk about those dimensions. It has the XL Voyager dimensions. So length, tip to tip, XL, 7 inches, and yes, I'm looking down at my notes to give you the metric as well as the imperial, 17.5 centimeters, which does fit in a standard front or back pants pocket. I'll demonstrate that in a bit. Thickness depends on where you're catching those diamonds exactly, but about 17 millimeters thick. thick. Width, okay, yeah, it's pretty wide in the pocket. How wide are we talking about? Widest point in the middle here, 2 1/4 inches, 5.75 centimeters, which makes it very, very close to the XL Voyager clip point and also the large Espada. Now, the large Espada is just a shave longer in the grip. Spot is also heavier. Spot is obviously going to get its own video, so to be continued. All right, well, how much weight are we talking about? Interestingly, compared to the other XL Voyagers, the drop point and the clip point, this one is a shave lighter. The clip point Voyager, which is a bit lighter than the drop point Voyager, is 7.5 ounces. This is 7.4 ounces, so 210 grams. So not that heavy in the pocket. A bit long, a bit wide, not too thick, not too heavy. Let's talk about the blade. Blade dimensions and, yes, the unique shape. Already talked about Aus 10A steel that my test files are saying is somewhere above 60 HRC. Nice keen secondary edge grind, super sharp full flat grind. Stone wash finish, which kind of self-polishes the more you use it. So yeah, it gets a little bit more of a matte satin finish as you work with it in terms of cutting things like wooden cardboard and such that are a bit abrasive on the surface. But, okay, specs. Has the Voyager XL blade length 5.5 inches, 14 centimeters. Same XL thickness if I'm measuring at the base, which is about 3.7 millimeters. Now, because of this blade shape, it does taper pretty rapidly down to, well, almost nothing. It's a very, very fine, slim tip in both profiles. Maximized for penetration, and we're going to see how that works. But are you sacrificing tip durability? Well, so far it hasn't failed on me in anything I've been doing with it yet, but yeah, it does worry me. It is a much thinner, keener tip. Are you doing too much of a trade-off to get that extra penetration? And are you getting significantly extra penetration out of that tip geometry? Well, we'll take a look at that here in a second. Put it to the test. But, okay, with the blade is, well, it's kind of hard to find the widest point. It's actually more down here at 1 5/8 inches, 3.5 centimeters. The recurve, all right, definitely gives me more belly. We'll talk about that in martial application and also utility application. But so far in my use, using it for cutting packaging and cardboard, and yes, I've done a lot of food prep with it. It's a little unusual, but you get used to it, and it actually functions for me using the belly versus using the kind of concave section here of the recurve of the edge. In function, it actually reminds me of using a smallish kukri, though a kukri is going to have more mass forward in the blade. This gets lighter as it gets closer to the tip. Where's the point of balance, by the way? Yeah, it's just like the other Voyagers. It's right in here in that finger groove. So yeah, your balance is right there at the top of your hand, not out into the blade. How does that feel in utility use and martial use? Well, let me go ahead and run the footage for my usual impact and durability tests. We'll talk about how it did, and I'll give you my martial impressions. So how did it do? With my other cold steel folders, I have had no concerns with how they're going to handle my impact and durability tests. This one, I was a little nervous about the tip. So starting there, thrusting and stabbing into my Pell. Stab him, several layers of thick cardboard backed up by a couple of inches of compressed brown paper, bag paper backed up by wood. And yeah, I would have to say the tip geometry compared to the other Voyager profiles, yeah, it penetrated very deeply with maybe less effort and more hooking action. It actually kind of got stuck. Now, I used a forward and a reverse grip, and in the forward grip, I went ahead and reversed the edge as well towards me, North American buoy style. The grip, not only the grooves, but the shape of the grip, the curvature, makes that feel really weird and wrong, but I figured I'd give it a try. And yeah, it worked, but it felt really weird and wrong, so I went back to conventional edge away from me. Really not a thing in the reverse grip. If I turn that around that way, it's just really... Yeah, that doesn't work for me. But penetration, awesome. And yeah, no bending, deformation, anything like that. Not that I was terribly worried, maybe a little bit. Speaking of worried, okay, the next test is potentially a little abusive. Bamboo test, trying to see if I can intentionally induce a chip or a roll in a fragile edge. Now, my other cold steel knives have straight out laughed at that test. I was a little worried with how keen this one is, but it did just fine. And interestingly, the curvature of the blade kind of bit in and grabbed and hooked the bamboo as I slashed at it at different angles to the point where it actually pulled it up. The stand mounting got pulled out of its base and tipped the whole thing over there at the end, which was kind of amusing. But it does give you a sense of how it would function in that kind of snap-cutting, slashing action. And yeah, absolutely no damage to the edge. Nothing loosened up under impact, felt just fine. Moving on to carving, I used a softer redwood board and a harder ash board. And yeah, you got to get a little bit used to the curvature. There's definitely a difference between cutting up here on the belly and down here in the in curve, which I tended to default to a lot, especially for fine work. Also naturally choking up, using the space here at the top of the grip to get real close, put my thumb up on the back of the blade. There's no jimping or anything like that, except for a couple of grooves on the plastic down here. Or locking my thumb above it. This is also how I use it when I'm doing food prep, by the way. Works really, really good for that, too. But yeah, nice carving tool. I think I like the more conventional Voyagers a little bit better. But yeah, this wasn't a problem. Chopping, though. With this end of the blade being lighter than the other Voyagers, I didn't think it would do as well. But I think a combination of the keenness and the belly geometry, it bit into those boards and chopping really deeply. Yeah, much more effective at doing that than I thought. I also did, well, potentially slightly abusive, you know, boring the tip into the wood, and did that okay. And yeah, I went ahead and did something potentially kind of stupid, which worked really well with the XL conventional blade shape, shall we call them, Voyagers, batoning cross grain through the boards. This blade shape is just really not shaped, built for batoning. It was really awkward and weird, and I was concerned with its durability, but I made it work. It got through the board. It was really strange doing so. I had a hell of a time trying to hit the blade in the right spot. Got through the board, didn't do any damage to it. Would I recommend that as something to use this knife for? Probably not. The other Voyagers, the clip point, the drop point, for me, much better in utility use all around. But this one did surprisingly well. So let's talk about its martial advantages. All right, down to the extra unflattering winter waistline view to talk briefly about pocket carry on a pair of pants. Fits just fine in a back pocket. This is often where I carry it, unless I'm carrying, you know, other things in my back pocket. But yeah, this is how much grip and how much, you know, corner steel you're going to see optics-wise. I have a reasonable amount to grab onto and pull it out pretty quickly and smoothly. Also fits really well in my front pocket, just right in there. Yeah, it is really grippy and potentially rippy on your pants unless you smooth out those diamonds under the clip. I haven't done much of that to this one, so it's a little extra grabby there. Okay, as mentioned, as I talked about the other Voyager knives, I think the one thing that this knife is absolutely missing is some sort of Emerson hook for quick out-of-pocket deployment. Because of the length of the grip and my short, stubby fingers, when I draw it out, I'm gripping it pretty low and then have to shift it up high to get my stubby thumb on that thumb stud to get it open. So there's an extra little tiny quick move in there. Compared to cold steel knives that have those hooks for really quick deployment, we're absolutely going to talk about those, but this one is still workable. Yet, if you had specifically designed this to be more of a Marshall Voyager, I think you really should have had that hook on there. Marshall application. Again, this blade shape was designed for Marshall effectiveness. How much of an advantage does it have over other blade shapes? Well, that's arguable, but it does have the same advantages of the other Voyager grip shape, especially in the XL length. You can choke up on it for that close use. Here in, well, just putting my index finger in the groove where the balance point is, where it seems like you're supposed to hold it, I am getting an extra inch of blade length reach out of this. If I choke down to the bottom hook, I'm getting over 2 inches of extra blade length reach, which puts your blade length in the same class as a lot of the bigger fixed blade Marshall knives we've been looking at. And speaking of which, yeah, being able to slash and snap cut with this, especially with that extra reach choking down, yeah, it is definitely competitive with some of those fixed blades we've been looking at. So I feel pretty confident with it that way. Now, when it comes to utility use, yeah, I'm still absolutely going to favor the conventional clip point. But, all right, the belly on this one in the slashing and the snap cutting and the chopping did impress me. The tip, yeah, it does penetrate deeper. It does feel like it would have more hooking action in stabbing, but you can get that tip pretty well in line. It's designed to be pretty straight line with the hand. So in straighter thrusting, yeah, you can get that tip on pretty readily, and it's held up just fine. I was a little nervous about how thin that was, but it did just fine. Also, there's just enough of a hook here. It's not sharpened on the back. I suppose I could sharpen that top like half centimeter, but it will bite in on a back cut, so you could use it for that hooking action. Now, in reverse grip, well, first talking about transitions, just like the other Voyagers, a lot of hooky business down here gets in the way of my stubby fingers pinch flipping, so I am defaulting to finger twirling, which I do not recommend because it's not very secure, but I've been doing it forever, so it's just my reflex default, and yeah, it's working here for me. But in the reverse grip, yeah, my grip sinks into that. I could put my thumb up on the back of the spine here if I wanted to. Yeah, it's really good for stabbing, really hooks into the target, penetrates very well. The slash with that belly, really effective. And I've got a good hook coming back the other way. So I mentioned turning it the edge the other way. That's just really, that's too strange. So I'm not doing that. But yeah, it's just, it is a very effective Marshall tool. But, okay, bottom line for me, that balance between good utility and good Marshall application, which means I'm going to carry it and use it a lot, maybe not as much as compared to this one if I'm thinking of more utility use. But when it comes to a similar knife size, shape, function that I feel might have the edge over it, Marshally and also potentially utility wise, okay, spoiler alert for our next installment, it is time to talk about the Espadas. But until then, let's get our conversation going. If you have any questions about this, if you happen to have this knife or other Voyagers, you have the serrated version, tell me about that. As always though, thanks for watching, liking the videos, following the channel, putting up with my madness, and I do hope to see you back for the next installments where we, yes, it's Espada time.